How would you 3D print this part right here? This is a vacuum hose adapter for my belt sander that will be constantly under load during use. Would you lay it flat on the bed, just as it loads into the slicer? Or would you place it on one of its ends, but risking it breaking during use? I actually went with neither and chose something in between. But does that really help? In this video, we'll take a deep look at the crucial topic of print orientation, how it affects appearance, support material, and most importantly, part strength, which I've tested with a bunch of tensile samples. So let's find out more. Guten Tag, everybody. I'm Stefan, and welcome to CNC Kitchen. This video is sponsored by KiwiCo. More on them later. We often overlook the importance of choosing the correct orientation when printing a part. I admit I often do the same and rely on the auto orientation feature in today's slicer, which optimizes the print for sufficient contact with the print bed and minimal support use. This improves printability, but doesn't necessarily find the orientation for best strength. While many understand that layer adhesion is a common issue in 3D prints, few realize how the performance of a part can vary depending on the orientation, and sometimes the best orientation isn't the obvious choice. Let's begin with a simple bracket. First of all, there is an indefinite number of orientations you could print this part in, but the two orientations most of us would probably choose are on its side or on one of the larger flanges. Printing it on the big face is great for bed adhesion and print reliability, but we face the problem that at the point of the highest stress, we have layer boundaries, right where the part will eventually break when it's loaded. One of the biggest challenges with filament-based 3D prints is their anisotropic strength. Anisotropic means that the properties of a material aren't the same in every direction. And for FDM prints, that means that they tend to break much easier if you pull the layers apart instead of along them. And the difference in strength can be significant. I printed a ton of samples for this video, especially to look at the strength of different print orientations. But let's start with the basics, and with parts printed at 0.2mm layers on the Prusacore 1 in Azofilm Green PLA. One set of samples was printed flat, whereas the other one was rotated 90 degrees and printed upright. I then loaded them one after the other in my tensile tester and pulled them apart until they failed. The horizontal samples had an average strength of 63 megapascals, whereas the ones printed standing failed at only half the load, 31 megapascals. And this is very typical for 3D prints. Practically no filament print is equally strong in all directions. The newly deposited layer will only partially melt onto the one below, and the polymer chains are primarily oriented in the printing plane, causing additional weaknesses. And just like testing my own 3D prints, there's always something special about learning by doing. And today's video sponsor brings that spirit right into your home, so your kids can become the innovators of tomorrow. This video is sponsored by KiwiCo, who makes amazing crates filled with hands-on projects that bring science, engineering, and creativity to life for kids of all ages. And even for adult kids like me. We've actually been KiwiCo subscribers long before they became a sponsor, and we still have tons of their materials because our kids love them. They're such high quality and definitely not throwaway items. KiwiCo sends these crates right to your doorstep. The panda crate for babies and toddlers comes every other month and helps lay the groundwork for learning and exploration. This time we got a beautiful wooden barn for my 1-year-old, and it's always incredible watching her have fun while developing new skills. KiwiCo always includes extra material for parents to help guide play and learning, which makes this way more than a toy. And with my 5-year-old, we built a treasure chest from the koala crate, which couldn't have been more perfect because she's currently super into treasure maps. Seeing her actually build something herself, use tools and learn new techniques, that was such a great family activity and a proud parent moment. KiwiCo has something for every age group and interest. The project I personally enjoyed the most was this basketball trash can. It was really cool to see how several simple manufacturing techniques came together to make a really cool mechanical trash can for some fun garbage disposal. If you're looking for something meaningful this holiday season for your own kids, nieces, nephews, or grandkids, KiwiCo crates are the perfect kind of gift that inspire curiosity, creativity, and hands-on discovery. You can go to kiwico.com/CNC or use the code CNC to get 50% off your first monthly crate. And if you're getting a panda crate for your little one, that code also gives you 20% off. So check out Kiwico. Their crates are much more than just toys. They inspire kids to become the makers and innovators of the future, and they are a fantastic way to spend time together as a family. Thanks to Kiwico for sponsoring this video. Now back to the 3D prints. Depending on the material, printer, and settings you use, layer adhesion is typically around 50% of the in-plane strength, as we've just seen here. It can go much higher with some materials, but also drop significantly if you, for example, print ABS with a lot of cooling. So, to increase the strength of our bracket without redesigning it, we simply place it on its side, so that the stresses when loaded are more aligned with the print lines, where the part is the strongest. But this can also lead to other problems with the bracket. Especially with warp-prone materials, printing on the side can cause the ends to lift and lead to print issues. And if you replace the standard through-holes with countersunk holes, we face another problem. When installing a regular wood screw into one of these holes, the tightening force will try to split the part. The layer lines again go directly through that hole, creating a weak point, which wouldn't have been the case on at least one of the sides when the bracket was printed flat. So, you see, even with such a simple part, the clearly strongest printing direction has still its own set of problems. When we go a step further and look at a corner bracket, we quickly realize that there's no ideal printing orientation anymore. Regardless of which side we place it on, there will always be one side pointing upwards where the part is prone to premature failure due to weaker layers. In such cases, we either have to compromise strength in one direction or come up with another plan. So, if we have a part where, in a normal printing orientation, one side is very strong while the other is very weak, is there a way to improve the behavior or at least make the strength more balanced? I mean, the strength of a 3D print is the best when the loads are along its layers and the weakest perpendicular to them. So, maybe we can just angle it to get something in between. But does this really help? Since I had the same question, I didn't only print tensile samples horizontally and vertically, I also printed them at 30 degrees, 45 degrees and 60 degrees angles and put them to the test. The results were seriously interesting. The horizontal samples from before were at 63 megapascals and the vertical ones at 31 megapascals. The three coupons printed at a 45 degree angle had a strength of 40 megapascals. That's still far from ideal, but angling the part improved the strength by 27% compared to the vertical reference, which is significant. The 30 degree samples were even a bit stronger, failing at 44 megapascals, whereas the 60 degree parts were weaker at only 36 megapascals on average. This aligns quite well with the analytical solution for orthotropic materials. The interesting thing here is that the strength doesn't change linearly between the best and the worst angles, but follows an S-shaped curve. The reason for this behavior would be too deep for this video, but the takeaway is that small angle changes from the ideal printing orientation don't do much, but past a certain point, the strength starts dropping fast. On the other hand, that means if you have a layer adhesion problem, angling the part only slightly won't help much. You should aim for at least a 45 degree angle, which is a good compromise between printability and strength gain. So, coming back to our corner bracket, printing it on its tip will improve the strength of its weakest member, while slightly reducing the strength of the others, but that still could be a good compromise. But printing a part at an angle isn't always straightforward though, because it often leads to minimal bad contact, in the case of the corner bracket, just a single point, which obviously won't work. If I didn't design the part myself, I often use a simple slicer trick. Rotate the part into the desired orientation and then use the cut tool to remove a small section of a corner or an edge, just enough to create a stable bed contact. At a brim and with good bed adhesion, that often prints fine, but you can also add some manual supports for extra stability. But you need to be careful here. I thought I was smart and did exactly that for my angled tensile samples. But all the prints with support failed, while the ones without them printed flawlessly. What happened was that even when printing PLA, parts always try to warp and curl up. Initially, the supports prevent this, but since part and support are only loosely connected, I mean, you want to separate them easily later, tension accumulates in the part until the support releases. Then the part springs up slightly and the nozzle crashes into it, ruining the print. You can get around this by designing custom supports that are only rigidly connected at a few points, and I'll link a video about that from the SLAN3D channel below. The dirty way is to just decrease the support object XYZ distance in the slicer and live with supports that are harder to remove, but hold the part firmly. Another often overlooked benefit of printing a part at different angles than you initially think is surface appearance. If you print a cube, the top, bottom, and the side surfaces all look differently, but printing the same part at an angle means all faces are printed with perimeters and basically look and feel the same. I mean, sometimes that's not what you want. Many products are designed so that the bottom layer remains visible because it looks so clean, but especially for organic prints, this can be a game changer. Just look at this relief print of Mount Fuji. One version is printed as it loads into the slicer and is also the way the author printed it, but that orientation leads to significant stair stepping, especially on shallow slopes. If we tilt the part 90 degrees on its side, it still prints great and produces a buttery smooth surface even at 0.2 mm layer height. This has a limit of course, but as long as the slope angle stays below roughly 45 degrees, everything's fine. Anything much lower and the perimeters start printing into thin air, or you'll see exposed infill. But you'd be amazed of what a 3D printer can do with good cooling and good materials. And this is not the only reason why surface quality can benefit from angled printing. I'm sure you've seen notches on outer surfaces, the most infamous being the 3D Banshee hull line, where a notch forms at the level of the deck. This is called a shrink line, and happens when the thin hull is suddenly pulled together when the full deck starts being printed, and the plastic shrinks when it cools down. A simpler example to understand this is this arch. At first, the two thin sides print independently, until the roof connects them. The plastic contracts, the sides are pulled inwards, and the next layer is printed at an offset, creating the visible notch. Printing this part at a slight angle not only improves the overhanging surface and almost eliminates the notch because only a small portion of the roof is printed in each layer, reducing deformation. So, if you print a 3D Banshee at an angle, the bow line basically disappears because the deck isn't printed anymore in one layer, but gradually over many. That doesn't mean that you should now tilt your Banshee, but it's important to understand why this happens and how angling can reduce shrink lines in FDM 3D prints. With everything we've learned, let's come back to the vacuum hose adapter for my belt sander. Especially for parts like this, thinking about printing orientation and its effect on strength, surface quality, and necessary supports is essential. Printing it flat is probably the worst choice. Not only does it require the most supports, ruining dimensions and surface quality, but even though it's now strong in one direction, it could split 90 degrees to it. Printing it on one of its ends seems ideal because it doesn't need supports, but now we have the layer boundaries at the worst possible position, perpendicular to the load and right at the stress concentration from the sander and vacuum hose. So I printed it at a 45 degree angle. Yes, that requires supports and a longer print time, but at this angle, I'm not only getting roughly 30% more layer strength, but the layers themselves are no longer aligned with the stress concentration points on the part. And printed like this, the adapter did a great job through the whole studio renovation last year. Thinking about printing orientation can transform a design from merely nice to look at into something truly functional. And sometimes the most obvious orientation might not be the best. If you download a model from someone else, think about what you want to achieve and align your part accordingly, because the default position in the slicer isn't always ideal. If you design a part from scratch, start thinking about orientation as soon as you draw your first sketch, because it can literally make or break your part. How is the part loaded? Can you adapt the geometry to avoid supports? Which surfaces need to be precise or clean? And please, once you share your model, export the STL again in the proper orientation, so others can print it as intended, because that's not always obvious and can lead to frustration. But I also want to be completely transparent here. Sometimes changing the orientation can make things worse. And this already starts with the quality of the corner bracket, when at this angle, the overhangs can curl up a little. You can also shift problems. Initially, my vacuum hose adapter broke during use, but when I first printed it at an angle, it split at 45 degrees during installation because it was too tight. Still, after printing that, it was super strong during use. Similarly, my test hook that I printed at an angle did not hold up more load than the one printed standing. And the point of failure just changed, because loading itself is complex. Also, the interaction between infill perimeters and top and bottom layers can cause issues. So, angling parts can help, but it's not always the magic bullet. Sometimes you need to think a bit out of the box, and this is where I need to highlight some parts of the multi-board organization system. This part clips into the baseboard and holds a bin. And at the obvious printing orientation, the hooks are weak. Printing them at a 45 or 90 degree angle would likely improve strength, but would require supports. So instead, they split the part in the middle and connect the halves with a thin bridge. When you finish printing, you fold it, resulting in a super strong and efficiently printed part. And there are plenty of parts where they do this, and it's really worth looking into. So kudos on that. 3D prints can be complex, and for most parts, there's no single best printing orientation, only compromises between strength, quality, accuracy, and supports. And all these factors often compete with each other. But if you just keep some of these findings in mind, your prints will not only look better, but also perform better. But what are your thoughts on this topic? How often do you change the orientation of a part to make it print better? And what's your prime example of making a stronger and cleaner part just by reorientating it? Let me know in the comments. Thanks for watching, everyone. I hope you found this video interesting. If you want to support my work, head over to Patreon or become a YouTube member. Also, check out the other videos in my library. I hope to see you in the next one. Auf Wiedersehen and goodbye.